Three, two, one. My name is Chinma Njoku, C-H-I-N-M-A-N-J-O-K-U. It was a massive culture shock in the sense that I lived in Kentucky before coming to Pocatello, and growing up in Kentucky, I was very fortunate to be around other Nigerians, so I thought that that was the normal, being around so many Nigerians and like having that diversity. So coming to Idaho, I didn't think twice, like, oh, just be around more Nigerians and just a different state. And then I come here and there is literally no Nigerians here. So that was a hard adjustment, but through basketball, I was able to find my community and find my like sense of belonging. When I first came to Idaho, basketball was the sport that like brought me my community. My last game, the championship game for 4A, the final game, and like we won the championship, I knew that I couldn't say goodbye to basketball. I was like, why should I say bye to it right now? Like, this is such a surreal moment. I want to continue, so yeah.
Just an elite level of athleticism that we hadn't seen before. And so it was very appealing to us, and she was raw and had some work to do, but had a great high school career. And then the athleticism stood out so much, and then once you get to know her and her personality, it was a no-brainer.
So I was being recruited for volleyball and basketball, so at the time I still didn't know what I wanted to choose, and then Boise State reached out to me a month before the championship game for 4A, and then coming on a visit here and seeing the culture and everything, I knew that Boise was perfect, the happy medium, like not too far away from home, but also not directly in Pocatello, so it felt right. It was interesting in the fact that I've been watching the team, so then meeting the players in person was, I don't know, like a full circle moment. And I remember it was actually a game day, so I got to see like game day vibes, like how they prep and how the coaches were, and it just felt right, and I knew that that was the culture I wanted to be a part, like they were standing on business, basically, so. It sounds weird to say, but I'm very grateful for the experience. I don't think I would be the woman I am today without going through those trials. I think everyone goes through trials in their life, and it just like gets them ready for their purpose, and I truly believe like it got me ready. Like now I have the mentality I can get through anything, so nothing really fazes me anymore.
It's great resiliency and the ability to just try to help. She has a giving spirit, and so she was a member of the team even though that she didn't maybe fulfill what she had hoped for athletically because of the knee injury. It was a terrible injury and affected her whole career, but she took the bright side of it also, and was an example to everyone in terms of academic commitment. And then also, she was a part of every day of practice, every game.
My support group was there for me from the beginning, and that made a huge difference. Just being able to know that I could go to my coaches, my teammates, or family at any time of the day and know that they always have my back. And even though they don't know exactly what I'm going through, they can at least sympathize with me and like just let me be heard. It meant the world to get a senior night, and I was just thinking like how I was freshman year when I redshirted, and then that night I was like, so much has changed and so much growth and development, and this just feels right, so yeah.
Oh, I think she'll be an incredibly successful, whatever she chooses to do. And she has an incredible family support group, and she has an amazing amount of academic success behind her. And she has a giving spirit, and one that was very active in Bronco life, and one that will continue that kind of stewardship and mentorship the rest of her life. I'm incredibly proud of her. I'm so glad that she was a Bronco, and what an example to everyone. If things don't go your way, you still make the best of it.
I love working in Bronco life. I'm very grateful for the group of people that are there. The project that I specifically worked on was the senior health and identity, so life after sports. And it really what resonated with me, because that's a whole process I went through last year medically retiring. So just getting to share my story to other seniors and just give them words of motivation and tell them, like, you guys can get through anything. We have all the resources and we're fully equipped for the next chapter of our lives. So it was just a great way to end my last semester helping other athletes with their personal development. I think I'm always like, go, 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 go. I don't take the moment to like really look back at everything. I think this week of like having the interviews and like talking to other people, I'm like, wow, like a lot has happened these past 4 years. But like to be called a role model is truly a humbling and great feeling, so yeah. Weirdly enough, I hate public speaking. So I was like, okay, I need to make this feel, I don't know, special in a way that it doesn't, I don't hate the whole process speaking. So I decided to be extra and get all the coaches and like the trainers a rose. And so I had a paragraph for each person. Like Coach P had his own paragraph, I'd read his paragraph and then have my teammates like hand deliver the roses to the people I was speaking of. And it just, it eliminated the crowd and allowed me to just focus on one person as I was speaking to them, and it felt personal. I've learned this past 4 years that I find a great sense of pride and identity through helping others. And so I'm going to nursing school, and then the end goal is to get my master's in nursing to be like a nurse practitioner, open my own clinic, and then I want to like specialize in labor and delivery. So I want to give other mothers, especially minority women, the opportunity to safely like give birth and have those resources, because my mom did. Her nurses were her guardian angels, and so I want to be that for a nurse, especially when they can't have family around. I want to no longer be a stranger but be a part of their life. I randomly got an email, and it was from my like the dean of health studies, and he was like, hey, like your academic achievements have like highlighted you as a person, and we want to give you this opportunity to speak at commencement. So we just need like a 2-minute pitch and like a letter of recommendation from anyone. So I used one of my professors. And then I submitted it. I was just like, you know what, why not do it? I got the opportunity my high school year, like high school to do it, but I was too scared. And I was like, okay, I'm not gonna let fear not let me do something I want to do. So I'm gonna try it this year. And then on a Monday, I found out I got into nursing school, and then that next day I got the email saying like, hey, you're giving the speech at graduation. I was like, oh my goodness. So yeah,
what a week.
It was a crazy 48 hours for sure. I'm just very grateful to be a part of this.